Welcome back to Daytime Ottawa. I am your host, Derek Fage, back to tell you about a wonderful event. It's actually three events put into one large event. It is called the Mississippi Mills Art Romp. It's a little bit of romp, a little bit of chomp, and a little bit of stomp. And Barbara joining me from the Mississippi Mills Art Romp to tell you all about it. Barbara, welcome to the show. Great to have you here.
Thank you. It's great to be here, Rick. It's great to have the opportunity to tell people about this event.
Yeah, Barbara, let's talk a little bit about the history behind this, because there are three tours sort of combined into one.
Yeah.
Did these three tours always have a close relationship?
Well, there's a lot of overlap because artists often do or participate in the three tours. So when Maple Run was canceled 2 years in a row, and Art in the Attic got canceled 2 years in a row, Crown and Pumpkin once, we decided that we should do something for the community and bring everybody together and give them a chance to basically get together and show their artwork and bring visitors in. So
Sorry, go ahead, Barbara.
Yeah, it's been quite an effort, but it's worth it.
Yeah, no kidding. And I'm sure you cannot wait to see people face-to-face. I know so many people have tried virtual events, but I think when it comes to art in particular, you know, to be there, to see the texture and to touch and to look, I mean, it's a really different feeling,
yeah.
Isn't it?
It is. It's, well, what we do requires the visitor to interact with us. When they come, they want to see the pottery, they want to touch the jewelry, they want to talk to the makers, to the creators. We have a fabulous potter who does absolutely wonderful and very practical tableware. He's been with the tour. His name is Clément Houek, and Clément has been with us for several years as part of Crown and Pumpkin Studio Tour. And we have the potters from the Almonte Potters Guild who are getting together to show off their wares. And I think we have another couple of potters who will be at the Cedar Hill Tree Farm.
Yeah,
so there's a lot to see.
Yeah, you mentioned over 45 artists and so many different mediums. You mentioned pottery and jewelry. Mm-hmm. What else can we find on the tour?
Well, there's woodworking. We have a wood turner who does the most incredible little objects, does turned wood pens, among other things. We have a honey supplier. We have a few photographers. And, of course, with Art in the Attic, we have a full range of all kinds of painting and photography. I'm trying to think of what we have. Fiber arts. We have a man who does quilting and makes hats and does decorated jackets. We have someone who does pinstriping. She does decorative painting on vehicles. There's one of those incredible pens. And of course, we have hot glass. There's a piece of my jewelry, just to give you a taste. And I have stuff here from the Almonte Potters Guild. One of our organizers is Catherine Stevens, who does these amazing bits of jewelry with crocheted silver wire following colorful palettes. She's inspired by the palettes of paintings.
Nice.
So we have a little bit of something for everybody.
Yeah,
oh,
for
craft
sure.
Beer, I forgot.
Oh, and yeah, of course, because you have beautiful heritage buildings. You also have, you know, the craft brewery to visit. So there's some different and very interesting locations along the way as well.
Yeah, there's that, and a lot of the visits will take you along what are considered to be the historic back roads of Lanark County, because Mississippi Mills is the name of the municipality now, but it takes in Almonte, Packenham, and the rural areas that include the villages of Clayton and Appleton and the area. So the scenery's beautiful,
The
colors are lovely right now.
Yeah,
it's a great
time to
get out on the road.
Yeah, I agree 100%. Well, we know the romp part. You mentioned some honey, so I'm guessing that's a bit of the chomp part of this tour, right?
That's a little bit of the chomp. And we're also, we're partnering with several of the local businesses and restaurants. Basically, we know that there's a lot of good food trucks in Almonte now. There's great restaurants. There's Cedar Hill Tree Farm does offer treats for takeout. And the Clayton General Store has food available for takeout, and you can sit on the patio and
nice
and have a meal there. And there's great restaurants in Packenham, so it's all there for you.
And Barbara, before I run out of time, just I've got 30 seconds left, but there is a stomp mm-hmm. aspect to it as well, right?
Yes, we're working with the Focus Music community to bring together performances at some of the larger venues. So there will be music at Cedar Hill Tree Farm, and I'm able to confirm that there will be music at the Clayton Community Center on Sunday.
Terrific. Barbara?
Romp, stomp, chomp. And enjoy the wonderful products. We've
exactly.
got such great stuff available.
October 9th and 10th from 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. Coming up after the break, we
Absolutely.
Have another fabulous event for you. Don't go anywhere.